We are ready now for the central limit theorem, example number 3. All right, so we are told that the mean weight for a certain population is 126 pounds, and the standard deviation is 15.7. All right, but if you read this question carefully, you never see any mention about being normally distributed, which is maybe a little bit of cause for concern. But here's where some important things happen here. Actually, it does say normally distributed. I lied. All right, so really, that is pretty important to know that this is normally distributed bell curve, that original variable. So this might be a question like we did on assignment 17, where we just have a normally distributed variable and we do it. All right, we just work it like we did before. But here's where the key words come into play. If a sample of 25 is selected, find the probability that the mean of the sample, the symbol for the mean of a sample is x bar. We're jumping over to a different variable, the mean of a sample, and that's really important to notice here, all right? So indeed, this does become a situation where we will apply the central limit theorem. We're jumping over to the mean of a sample. So the mean for this distribution would equal the 126, just like the other, but the standard deviation has changed. It'll be that 15.7 from the original divided by the square root of the sample size. And again, if we go back and read the question, we will see that the value of n is the fact that they sampled 25, all right? Which the square root of 25 happens to be 5. You're welcome. We can do that one in our head. So anyway, this new standard deviation turns out to be 3.14. Wow, that's almost like a piece of pie, isn't it? Well, maybe I need to put on my pirate hat then so that we can finish solving this, right? So a little bit of a little drop-in from Long John Solvers, all right? My agent got me a deal with Long John Solvers. We speak math, and I just made some extra money there. Appreciate that. All right, so anyway, 3.14. How interesting was that? Anyway, we're jumping over to X bar. Now, let's go ahead and read the rest of the question. What's the probability that the mean of the sample, which means the symbol now is X bar, the variable, and it says greater than 128.3. All right. Now, one of the things that we need to remember, and this could cause confusion, but here's the deal. We talked about you have to sample at least 30 for this to be a bell curve, and they only sampled 25. Oh, no! But that's why it was really important that they told us that that original variable was normal. And if it is, there's no criterion that needs to be met as far as your sample size. So, yeah, this new variable x bar that we jumped away from our x and ran off to the x bar, it is indeed a bell curve. All right, and now it's like, goodbye x. I ran off with x bar. I jumped over to x bar. So the mean of this new variable is 126, and we're talking about 128.3, it said greater than, right? So y'all by now are like, that looks like an upper tail picture there, Mr. I'm trying to find a good one here, I don't know, Mr. Singapore? I don't know. Anyway, this would be the point in time where we would standardize this. And so we'll take that 128.3 minus 126, x minus mu over sigma, right? Remember that little translator that we talked about on assignment number 17, z equals x minus mu over sigma. Let me write this down over here to remind you of that. And that turns out to be 0.73. So, being Mr. Visual here, have I told you guys that it helps to draw a picture? So we got a Z now, bell curve 0 in the middle, 0.73, greater than 0.73, right? Different scale, same looking picture, and now you're hopefully going, oh, that is so assignment 16 at this point in time. So then we would be able to go to our table. All right, stop, table time, do, 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 do. We look up 0.73, and it turns out that 0.73 in that table will give us a little sliver of 0.2673. That's what I found earlier. Let me confirm that. Kind of defeats, yeah, it's there. All right, 0.73 gives you a middle sliver. Looking at the picture, which I think is extremely helpful since we want that upper tail, as practiced on assignment 16, we would take the upper half of the bell curve, subtract that middle sliver, and that'll leave the upper tail that we wish to determine. So this would be 0.5 minus 0.2673, and that comes out to be 0.2327. So this is all old stuff that we did before, and that's why I'm going through that part of the question pretty quickly. So there you go, that would be that probability there. And you know, and again, the key thing would be we're finding a probability related to the mean of a sample, and that was our motivation to jump over to X bar and apply the central limit theorem. The fact that we jumped. Believe it or not, I'm still dancing behind the camera. Maybe I'll wear my clothes backwards. Or not.